state and explain Coulomb's law, then derive Newton's third law of motion using Coulomb's law. This can also be asked that state and explain Coulomb's law, then prove that it is consequence of Newton's third law of motion, or prove that Coulomb's force is a mutual force. These three questions may be asked in different angles, and there is only one answer of this question. So first we have to state the statement of Coulomb's law. Here gives the statement. It states that the magnitude of force of interaction between two charges is directly proportional to the product of two charges and inversely proportional to the square of mean distance between two charges and acts along the line joining the two charges. Or simply or easily, we can write the force of attraction and repulsion in between two point charges is directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Here, two charges Q1 and Q2 are present, and R is the separation distance between them. Now, we can write mathematically, F is directly proportional to Q1, Q2 and inversely proportional to R square. Now, F is directly proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. That implies F is equal to beta into Q1, Q2 by R square, where beta represents the proportionality constant known as Coulomb's constant. In CGS system, F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square for a vacuum. Here 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is the value of beta. And in CGS system, 1 by 4 pi epsilon value becomes 1. That is equal to F is equal to Q1 Q2 by R square for vacuum. Now, the derivation of Newton's third law. First, we have to state the statement of Newton's third law. What is the statement of Newton's third law? That states action and reaction are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Or simply we can write every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So let us consider two charges Q1 and Q2 situated at point A and B in XY plane. Let R1 and R2 vector are their respective position vectors. So now F1 2 vector is the force acting on charge Q1 by charge Q2. See the figure here. In XY plane, Q1, Q2 are the two point charges situated at point A and B. Here, R1 vector and R2 vector at the position vector of Q1 and Q2. Here, F12 vector represents the force acting on charge Q1 due to charge Q2. And F21 vector is the force acting on charge Q2 due to charge Q1. So now, according to Coulomb's law, F12 vector becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by magnitude of R21 vector. So F12 vector becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by magnitude of R21 vector to the power 2 into R21 cap. Here R2n cap represents the direction of R2n vector. We know A vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into A cap. Okay. We know A vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into A cap, where A cap represents the direction of A vector. Similarly, here r2n vector is r2n cap is the direction of r2n vector. So we can put the value of r2n cap, that is equal to r2n vector by magnitude of r2n vector. So now f2n vector becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into qn q2 by the square of magnitude of r2n vector into r2n vector by magnitude of r2n vector, that becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by the cube of magnitude of r2n vector into r2n vector, that becomes the equation 1. Consider as it becomes equation 1. Now according to triangle law of vector addition, see the image or figure, the triangle OBA, OB vector plus BA vector becomes OA vector, R2 vector plus R2 and vector becomes R1 vector. So R2 and vector is equal to R1 vector minus R2 vector. This becomes equation 2. Okay, r2n, the now magnitude of r2n vector is equal to magnitude of r1 vector minus r2 vector. This becomes equation 3. Now using equation 2 and 3, equation 1 we get f1 vector is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 by cube of magnitude of r1 vector minus r2 vector into r1 vector minus r2 vector, which becomes equation 4. Similarly, we can write f2n vector is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 by cube of magnitude of r2 vector minus r1 vector, this becomes r1 vector, into r2 vector minus r1 vector. This becomes equation 4. Sorry, equation 5. But R2 vector minus R1 vector is equal to minus of R1 vector minus R2 vector. And R2 vector minus R1 vector, magnitude of R2 vector minus R1 vector is equal to magnitude of R1 vector minus R2 vector. So it becomes equation 5. Now F2n vector is equal to minus of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by R1 vector minus R2 vector to the power 3 into R1 vector minus R2 vector. This is the magnitude. Now comparing equation 4 and 6, we get f2n vector is equal to f minus of f12 vector. This becomes f12 vector. Please correct it. Which is Newton's third law of motion, that is every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Okay.